Hello everyone and welcome back to CLGTR channel. So today this video I'm gonna show you guys how to draw cloud in Medibang Paint Pro. Okay, here's the result. You can see that after working and drawing a little bit here, and when I finish this, I add a little bit detail for the birds and the field here. So I will turn this off to see show you guys what actually you will have when you finish this tutorial. Okay, here is the result, and now I will show you how to do it. Okay, so to start this tutorial, I will create a new file to show you guys what I did from the beginning. The result may be not the same like this one because I spent more time on it, and this one is just for demo for the tutorial. Okay, and first I will use the pencil bin here for a sketch. And here, when you draw the cloud, you must create the skate and the set first. I will draw the cloud. There's many ways for you to draw the cloud. I also find some tutorial on the internet. You can see that they will draw the circle like this one and add another circle and another circle and another circle for this one to create a set of the cloud. And for me, I find something more to fun way to do it. So I will draw something that I like at first. Like I will draw a popsicle like this one to create the shape of the cloud, and maybe the hand that's holding a popsicle like this. This is the shape that I want to create. Then I will lower this opacity and create a new layer for this one, and starting to draw the cloud based on the popsicle shape like this. Now turn this one off, and to make it look more naturally, I will add some more cloud around here. That's it. The next step that I will create a new layer, drag it below the sketch layer, and then I will use the gradient tool. Now I will pick two colors for this one. First is the dark color, a blue. The dark blue would have shadow rotation a little bit and more darker a little bit around here. Then the lighter color here. Now the tie is foreground and background. I will use the gradient tool here, drag from the bottom to the top because I want the foreground color here will be in the bottom. Okay, drag it like this. Kinda a little bit too dark for me, so I will change it again, the color again. Okay, it looks kinda okay. If you don't like the color, you maybe want to go to the future and pick hue here, or simply use command or control with you, and then more high shadow rotation, a little bit more brightness, change the hue here, and then click OK when you're satisfied with the result. Okay, now I will lock this layer because I don't want to mess with it anymore. Okay, now I will create a new layer and use the fill brush. The fill brush in here will help you to fill everything based on what you draw. Okay, like this one, and it will automatically fill it. Now I will go with the white color for the cloud. Okay, you can see that there's some part of the cloud here maybe behind the order, so I will create another layer for this one. First I will draw this cloud. Okay, then I will create a new layer for this cloud, and you will have this result. Okay, here is the cloud you have. Okay, go back with the sketch. I will draw the small cloud later. Okay, now I go back with the sketch. This is the hardest part. You will imagine about the shadow and the lightning. Even the cloud will also have the light source. Okay, here you will have the light around here to make the source of the light, and then it will also cast the light around this part, and then it will cast the shadow around this part. So now I will draw the shadow, the light will around here, okay? And the shadow for this one is will be around here. Now I will create new layer for each one here and choose clipping. Then I will use fill tool again, fill brush again, and pick the light, the lightest color of the sky, then move it a little bit to the white in here because I don't want it to shadow rotation. Okay, and I will draw the shadow of this one. You can see when I turn off the skate layer, it will look like this one. Okay, now I just finished the shadow of the cloud, and you see this one is the result. When I create the popsicle image for the cloud, it will help you easier to think about the shadow. And then you can move it to the transparency box in here to erase some part if you don't like it. Retouch something around here. Okay, that's it, and now you will have the shadow of the cloud. Next, I will use Protect Alpha for each clipping layers here, and then I go back with the gradient tool. And now the next thing is that I will make the color look more beautiful, so that's why I will add more purple here, just because I like purple, that's why. And now I want the light color will be at the bottom, so that's why the foreground is the lighter color, and drag it from the bottom to the top. The next one here. And here is the result that I have it. The next thing is that you see that the shape of cloud, some parts in here is not really naturally. So I go back with the base shape layer here and use my old brush. Here, that's my old brush here. I just make it custom when drawing the clouds, and you can also download it and use it for free. I will upload the brush and the setting on my Facebook fan page later. Okay, now I will use my brush here and pick the white color. Draw it around the edge like this to make the cloud look more naturally. You can also use the transparent box to erase some part. Okay, and you are done. Now the final thing for the retouch something here, I will use the blur tool, the blur brush in here, and I will pick the clip layer to make all the shadows in here look blurry because I don't like the safe look of this one. Remember to uncheck the protect alpha so it can be worked like this. Okay, this step is optional because maybe some of you guys will like the result before more than this one. Here is the result for you guys. You can maybe spend more time to draw more shadow, anything else in here to add more of this. And for more retouch, more details, I will add a new layer, use the fill tool again, and choose a dark color here. Draw some optional cloud. And here you are done. For my work here, I will add some change to make it look more beautiful. That I will create a new layer and I will change the mode to overlay. Then I will use the fill tool here and choose the color around here, then drag the whole picture. You will see that the color of cloud is changing. You can go back with the fill and hue here to change the hue, the shadow rotation, the brightness to make the color look more beautiful, and until you satisfied it, and then you click OK. Here is my my changing color, and then I will add some final detail. And that's it. That is all about this tutorial. Hope this will help you guys drawing better. Thank you for watching and see you next time.